So, Emily.
Yeah?
Last night I woke up and I had been sleeping on my arm such that, like, it felt completely disconnected from my body.
Yeah.
Like, more so than ever before. Like, I rolled over and my arm kind of came with me, but I couldn't feel it at all. So it was just like...
I hate that.
Having a tube of jelly that just dangles from your shoulder.
Don't say that. Oh, God, I don't like that. Oh.
Yeah, it was really gross. And then my hand hurt all day today. I think they're related.
Oh, definitely.
Congratulations, you did your damage to yourself.
Oh, probably. God, it still really hurts. I can't
grab anything. You're messing with it. You're totally messing with it right now. I can tell.
What? No,
you're messing with it.
No, I'm not. I'm trying to massage it.
Yeah, you're messing with it.
That's not messing with it. You're supposed to do that.
Says who?
Says...
A masseuse?
My intuition.
Says my your intuition a masseuse?
Wait, okay. The other thing that I've been meaning to tell you about and I keep forgetting is I watched, like, the coolest compilation on YouTube the other day that I've ever seen. If you want to guess what it is? It's vaguely related to what we're talking about right now, which is why I remember it.
Oh, then I have no clue.
Okay. It was just, like, a compilation of people just getting chiropractic work done.
Oh, that's interesting.
And it's so cool, dude.
That sounds really cool.
It looks really cool. It's just like, it's like these guys, and then, like, you know how when you think of popping someone's back, it's like, you think of it kind of being, like, gradual?
No,
like,
I don't.
Like, or you go like, you know, like when you back punch or something, it's like, ba 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 ba, and then it, like, kind of pops a couple times.
Well, that's a series of sudden pops.
But when you get chiropractic work done, they literally, it's like a kung fu strike. They're like, and they push into your back really hard, and, like, it kind of rocks the whole table that you're laying on, and, like, it's amazing.
Well, I know what I'm getting you for your birthday. Chiropractic work.
No, but I saw this one where, like, this guy had, like, this is kind of gross, so, it's, but, you know.
I touched dead babies in a closet for 2 years. You can't, it doesn't work. You're fine.
Okay, great. All right, so there's this guy with, like, this big fluid deposit in his back.
Oh, yeah.
The chiropractor, like, he just, like, nails him. He's like... And the guy, like, yells. He's like, oh, and then you can literally watch his back deflate, and it's nuts. Yeah. Like, the grossest. It's really gross, but it's really incredible.
Weren't we, like, doing a murder mystery?
You were, but again, as I've mentioned, we are stepping back to the beginning of that adventure because I don't remember how, like, most of the details that were kind of happening and how we were dealing with them. And since it's been 2 months, we're just gonna do that beginning part again.
Okay.
And it, again, won't take very long because you've already done it, and focus this time.
Yeah, sure.
It's also a lot easier, Anna, to introduce a new character at the beginning of the adventure.
Yeah. So, no, I'm just a little skeptical of it going faster.
Well, at the very least, it'll go better.
I'm skeptical of that, too.
You'll have a friend this time. Another friend. So, it is dinner time at Paperbacks. That's where you guys have your rooms. The nice subterranean dining
Trader
room.
Trader Mass. It's Market. Trader Mass Market. Paperbacks?
Oh.
Bookseller jokes.
It's an assorted private collection. They do have a... they do actually sell some books. They're not a full bookstore, but they have a private stock that they cater for either in-house reading or purchasing. But the party has nice, still fairly affordable rooms here and are eating dinner. Party. You have gotten back to your rooms after a long day dealing with ghosts. Or a ghost. And as you are eating at the table, a very tall, I would even say gaunt, you know, almost haunted in appearance.
Jesus Christ, you can just say it's
young
me.
Woman.
Young woman.
Go on.
enters the room, hunching somewhat beneath the brick-arched ceiling. She quickly spots you three out of the small crowd drinking that night.
Hey!
Oh my god.
Hey girl. The 50-year-old
sorcerer.
Yeah, I guess sorcerer. What do you even wear? Like,
I wear it
Ray-Ban like, sunglasses? Yeah, so the 50-year-old in aviators says,
inside.
Hey.
Inside at night.
Mm-hmm. Indoors, yeah. At night.
Is 43. I think y'all know that.
I'm glad I do know that.
I'm not.
Yep. Okay. I see them.
Mm-hmm.
We're very distinctive.
Are they?
The young woman stands awkwardly in the middle of the room staring at you.
Yeah,
I stare back.
Sounds about right.
I wiggle my fingers for her.
Awkward.
Poppin'.
You guys work at the library, right?
Yes.
Junior apprentices?
Are you yelling this to us, or you want to come over and talk?
No. I'm, like, shuffling my feet.
It's not that large of a room. She doesn't need to... When she's speaking under her breath in terror, you can
dancer.
Hear her.
Well, she'll come over when she's ready.
I'm magic.
You can't force these kind of things.
I can make my hand look like a ghost.
Whoa.
Wait, no, that's sound. I can make my sound look like a ghost. Oh my
God. I can make my hand sound like a ghost.
Woo!
Frankly, I don't know how any of that would work.
I can also see you invisibly.
Prestidigitation.
And I can really impress you with my grabbing.
Oh yeah, did you take that feet impressive grab?
No, it's called shocking grasp.
Same thing, really.
Okay.
Ruin them. Can I help you?
Oh, goodness.
That was really good.
Just got hired there. They said you'd probably be here. I wanted to introduce myself before I got murdered on the battlefield.
That's the spirit.
I like your style. What's your name?
Kay.
Hi, Kay. I'm Kay.
Like the
this
letter?
This is Corn Cop. He thinks he's a cop. He's actually no actual affiliation to any police department anywhere.
I'm the authority.
He's an idiot. Ignore him. And
I'm the law.
Logan, I don't actually remember your character's name.
Perkins.
Perkins Lone? Yeah, I'm not sure what he's good for.
Perkins.
Something. He's good for not having as much debt.
Something. He's good for something.
Right, so...
That's on my card. Perkins Lone, good for something.
And on that...
And I say, that's up to you to figure out, and I wink.
You're a winker too.
Sit down!
How old is your character, Logan?
I don't remember. I think he's my age.
I mean, he's got an 8-year-old kid, doesn't he?
I figured he was in, like, his 30s or 40s.
I think... Nope, character sheet says 22.
Oh! Wow! Busy.
You had a kid when you were, what, 14?
It's possible.
It was a different time.
It was a different time!
Who was the mother?!
It was 8 years ago.
Well, okay.
The mother was Mrs. Lone.
Mrs. Lone?
You got married at 14?
No, she's currently Mrs. I don't want to get into it.
I'm just impressed you're actually married.
Listen, my private life is my private life.
You mean you haven't figured out how fucked up your past is yet?
Do you live in a trailer park?
He lives with you guys.
Do you live in a trailer park?
None of you have permanent housing.
Hey, I just live wherever the department wants to put me.
You're not live with us?
I'm not going to have this argument with you right now.
I go where I'm assigned.
Hey, you know, there's no place like home when you're the law.
Wherever there's crime that needs copping.
Poppin'.
I turn to Kay and say, would you like a drink? Or something?
Are
you sane or have any kind of... why am I even asking you that? Find out in time. Would you like a drink?
I would love a drink. Love it. Heard.
And on that note, welcome to episode 6, sort of redo of 5. Seravek. That was the intro before we hit like the theme music.
Oh, okay.
That isn't. We don't actually structure this like a TV show, but if we did, that's how it would work. I just picked silly intro music that's in public domain.
I know, but
you have to do Librarian by My Morning Jacket.
That's not in the public domain, and I'm not paying them.
You just have to kill everyone from My Morning Jacket and then wait 70 years.
Good time.
If I kill them, do I get the rights?
No, that's you just keep it them? Takes that long for something to become public domain.
No, but I mean, if you kill everyone who owns the rights, does it then pass to
you?
No, you
then go to jail.
No, I think you have to take their wand.
That's how the law works. I'm sorry to break it to you.
No, you have to go expelliarmus.
Uh-huh. I'm not. The music industry is international waters. If you can get away with that.
Definitely not true.
No, that's all that pirate radio is about.
Then it would be My Morning Jacket.
No, it isn't. Pirate radio is all about swashbuckling and rum.
So if you kill a pirate, and then you wait 70 years,
then you get a curse.
Does his ship become public domain?
No, you become cursed.
That is actually what the Goonies is about, so yeah.
I think that comes under, like, international salvage laws.
Taylor, have I ever told you my opinion on The Goonies, which is it has the best ending of any movie?
You've never told me this.
Because they have a fucking pizza party, and that's how every
they
movie
do.
Should
that was,
end.
That was their entire goal from the beginning, was to
I
have
know,
a pizza
and
party.
It's amazing.
To not have their houses torn out and to have a pizza party.
That's how every movie that's meant to have a happy ending should end. Just like everyone's parents show up with pizza.
Yeah,
all right, well, let's
yeah,
that's
pretty
this.
Good.
Wizard of Oz, that'd be a weird one.
That'd be amazing. She gets back in Kansas, and they're like, oh my god, we're so happy to have you back. We got pizza.
The tornado just deposited a Domino's outside of our door.
like the end of Star Wars, where they're getting, like, the medals or whatever, and then just, like, everybody in the crowd is, like, eating pizza. There's a knock on the door, it's the Domino's guy, they're like, hey!
Are we actually, like, playing, or are we just discussing movies? Is this a podcast now?
I'm assuming we were talking about this in the bar.
Yeah.
We're podcasting
in the bar. That's how it works.
Of course, because the Goonies and pizza exist here.
Mm-hmm.
Why not?
It's
Why
just a book.
Why not? Why am I even arguing?
Well, yeah,
I read
we
it
got
in a book.
Weird, we got, well, pizza should definitely exist, because Taylor sent us on, like, ethnic food mission.
Oh, yeah, that's
yeah, no, if...
Taylor, if pizza doesn't exist in your universe, I will be very disappointed in you.
It's not really a regional thing here, but, like, one...
What do you mean a regional thing?
Like, it isn't really popular around here, but it's not, like...
But, like, the
what
means
do you mean it's
to
not popular?
Make it
it's
exist.
Pizza.
Doesn't mean it's, you know, like, eaten around here. Like,
what kind of party are we supposed to have after we complete...
Look, I'm sorry... I'm sorry, I'm not saying that, like, bread with, like, melted cheese and meat on it is, like, non-existent in this world. It's just, you know, not here.
We'll work on it.
The pincho community is devoted.
Oh. All right, new task. Nice bring pizza to the town.
Yeah.
Culinary revolution.
Do you have any questions for your new party member? Or do you just, like, trust she knows what she's doing?
No, I don't. But the only way to tell if she's sane is to watch her closely and find out.
It's all right.
Although, given my previous examples of insanity, I won't have to watch very closely.
Michaela, can you remind me of your name?
Kay.
Okay. Now, yeah, what's your name?
This is gonna be...
Who's on first?
Would you like my full name, or just the first name?
Let's do full. I need it for my notes.
Okay. K. Nahoa. There's an apostrophe.
Let's just go first. Let's just go first name.
K-E apostrophe I.
K-E apostrophe I. Okay.
Nahoa. N-A-H-O-A is the last name.
No.
Can you type that out?
No, I'm making my best attempt at it.
I got it right!
Well, she
no,
did
I
just
didn't.
Spell
I
it.
That extra I.
I did just
Why?
Spell it.
Why is there an utterly unnecessary apostrophe in your name?
Because Hawaiian.
She's descended from elves.
Oh, she's one of those Pokemon with, like, the fucked up faces.
Oh, yeah.
What?
It's what happened to Pokemon. They went
Here.
To Hawaii.
Yeah, they went to Hawaii and their faces got fucked up.
Well, it's really... No, it's really just Persian.
Well,
the rest of them look totally the same. They're just different colors.
Picture. This goddamn thing.
That's pretty bad. That's pretty bad.
Yeah.
What is that?
That's what Meowth evolves into.
It looks like goddamn yep. Garfield.
Oh yeah, no. I caught it in like
they used
the
to be
first
real.
Town I was in. I was like, what the hell is this shit? What is this guy? And then you're like, oh yeah. People here really liked the Persians, and so they started breeding them, and we just like the ones with the big faces. So
they just bred the same two over and over and
yeah.
over.
Is this a...
yes.
It's a commentary on pugs.
It is a commentary on pugs. Holy shit.
This used to be something we would respect, but now its eyes pop out if you touch it too hard.
The worst thing about gaming with you guys is that it's almost impossible to write down these full, ridiculous conversations.
The Meowth also gets, like, sassy eyes.
Yeah, the Meowth looks cooler, and the Persian looks worse.
You can tell why you breed it that thing. It's like, hey, bonus.
I honestly don't think I have ever fallen in love faster than I fell in love with Ratatatas with a mustache.
Wait, there's a Ratatata with a mustache?
Yeah.
Yes!
I showed you that. I showed you his mustache.
Oh my god, you did.
Yeah, it looks stupid.
It looks really stupid.
It looks stupid, but I fell in love immediately. I was like, oh my god.
I want to see this Ratatata with a mustache.
Isn't the Raticate is just like super fucking fat too, right?
Yeah, he's all poof.
They had to know when they designed that Persian that it looked fucking, like, absurd.
The funny thing is, that's the one that everybody talks about in Alola. Like, when they reference that there's some that look different, they're usually talking about Persian.
Yeah.
So they're definitely acknowledging
it's
it.
It's hard to miss. Just,
like, the normal Persian has, like, the facial definition of a large cat. And then this one just, like, has the facial definition of a balloon.
Yeah.
That someone, like, drew on with a Sharpie marker.
I also have
a
creeping suspicion.
It was a huge disappointment.
It's shaped like a flounder.
Well, it's like they just took Meowth's head and put it on Persian's body.
No, but it's
yeah,
also
really weird.
Probably about a centimeter thick as well. It's not like the shape of a head.
Meowth? Persian kind of looks like, you know, like a grown-up thing, and Meowth looks like a cartoon. And they just blended that together in the worst possible way.
And Ratatata just looks like an Italian man.
Yes.
He does.
Well, you do know that Hawaii is where Italian men come from.
Wait, what? What?
Yeah, all Italian men are from Hawaii. Didn't you see that movie?
No, I didn't.
The Italian Job.
Yeah, no.
It's about a guy who works at a surf shop.
It's like all dogs go to heaven, but with Italian men in Hawaii.
Okay.
Get the bucket list if they go to Hawaii.
Okay, at that, that's the joke where I decide it's time to rein it in.
Alright.
We've all lost our privileges from other conversations.
I guess the only thing, I'm going to try and get us back on track a little bit. Taylor sort of started the thing where he described what I looked like when I walked in the room, which is like very tall, very gaunt, like sickly looking. But now that I'm closer to you guys, you actually can see that there is no color to me. Like, I am white.
Are you playing another fetchling?
I am.
This is a humans only campaign! Taylor, you told me this was humans only!
It is.
Why is she a fetchling?
She's not a fetchling. At least no one's ever heard of a fetchling.
Oh, that's a weird-looking son of a bitch!
No, I told you exactly what I mean. It's, you know...
That's a weird-looking human.
Yeah.
It's a
motherfucker.
Weird-looking human.
Have you seen Persian?
No, shut up.
That's a weird fucking thing.
There's such things as regional variants.
Yeah. That's true. This is her, the Alolan form.
The Alolan form.
Yes, so in a sort of metagaming, we can all acknowledge Michaela is not a human. Or is she not? She's not something purely human. However, in the context of this world... as I've mentioned in the past, this is a humans-only world in the sense that the known continent, which is very well explored, barely even has monsters. There are no other sentient humanoids.
Weird. So, like, are we, like, racist? Or
no,
racist?
They're just fairy tales, basically.
Yeah,
so, racist.
So in the last 3,000 years, there you don't actually have evidence of that. But you also haven't circumnavigated the globe.
Right, so racism. This is where monsters come from.
Sort of.
But I'm not... I'm still... Fetchlings
are... Do you
are...
know that you're a fetchling?
I know that I'm a fetchling.
Fetchlings I'm a fetchling?
Are... Yep. Fetchlings are humans that grew up on a different plane, and the plane affected them. So technically human, but also technically not.
Mm-hmm.
Were there snakes there?
I wish, or... Oh, by the way, guys, I'm getting a snake on Wednesday.
Really?
Wait, don't you have a snake?
A hog nose.
Oh, they're so cute!
They are!
He's two years old,
and he's very sweet. The first time I met him, he wanted to go in my cleavage, and that's how I knew he was the one.
That's the best kind of snake.
Snake that wants to get down your shirt, but not your pants?
We have a name for that in anatomy.
What?
Seriously?
What?
Yeah, I'm interested to know, too.
You do not know the word for the snake that's interested in cleavage and anatomy.
Oh, you mean a dick.
Yeah.
We just thought it was a little more complex of a joke. We expected better of you in that moment.
We weren't expecting it.
My jokes are always good.
Yeah, so...
It's just...
Returning to Kay, it's clear
she's... Hawaiian fetchling.
Yeah, she doesn't look like she's from around here, in that she's unusually tall. It's definitely not unheard of. She's only, like, what, 6'2", you said?
Like, Logan tall? Oh, so
shorter like,
than
a little unusual, but nothing, like, troubling.
A neck.
Yeah. Yeah, she's very pale, like... Probably like dishwater gray hair or something like that.
Favorite color.
But, you know, she seems, you know, normal enough, not threatening. In a fight, well, you could probably take her without much trouble because she's, like, very brittle and thin.
Yeah, the wind probably pushes me around a lot.
Yeah, I feel like I'm going to have to protect you from my fellow party members.
The important thing to remember is that you still don't have anyone who can take a hit.
Fuck, you're right.
It's not my fault.
No.
Again, I don't feel like libraries are going, you know what we need in our acquisitions teams? Dumb and can take a hit.
Actually, many places do.
You clearly have not met the head of acquisitions.
I'm sorry, no. Guys. It's my fault. I should have more hit points. I'm the tank.
I'm the tank.
Logan. Taylor, can I go buy some armor?
You just roam out into the streets with whatever song is playing for Ringo in A Hard Day's Night as he's just wandering along the riverside, dejected, because he's the lesser of the Beatles. Yeah, Logan, you can go do that if you really want to. In
no,
the night.
Well, let's see.
So you just leave for no reason, and we're all just, like, Kay looks confused, and I'm just like, leave him, he'll be back.
Yeah, eventually. But, Michaela, fun fact. Most heads of acquisitions are actually ex-military for that exact reason.
Yeah, but...
I still want to be best friends with Grimjaw.
They want punchy people. Or at least a balance of punchy people and smart ones.
No. No punching. Just sickness. Definitely sick.
Yeah. But...
What?
You know, she is your new addition. Only time will tell how she fits your party composition. Now, whatever time you retire, that's up to you. But in the morning, if I remember how we did it last time, Anna Karya is awoken by a rat tatting upon her window by Lord Tensley.
Mr. Whitey the Business Weasel?
No. Lord Tennisley is a Fluvia's weasel. Mr. Bitey belongs to Corey Golden Gray.
Corey Golden Gray still has the best name.
Yeah, she's the teenager. Whereas Effluvia's your boss. Assistant head of acquisitions. Michaela, she's also the one who hired you.
Cool.
She's just a very angry person.
Yeah, sounds about right.
So, yes. Anna, you are awoken by that, and the letter in his tube, written in neat, small script, is simply, library now, be subtle, but be prepared.
I like it.
Okay.
Sick.
How does one subtle butt?
That's up to you.
Well, I go acquire my,
That's a great question.
I will hire my fellow Jacks and tell them we need to go. And I'm not even going to bother mentioning the beat subtle bit because I know that'll just make it worse.
I think you're probably right.
If right. I tell them to be subtle, they will become consciously less subtle.
Mm-hmm. Party, is there anything you would like to do to prepare or just go with your equipment as you are?
We would like to party. That's what we'd like to do.
Hmm.
Let's go to the pizza party.
Okay. You were disappointed by the pizza party because it is only Effluvia who showed up and she didn't bring pizza.
Rude!
Instead, she brought a frown.
Ain't that some shit.
That sounds like Effluvia.
Yep.
I say hello regardless.
Hi!
Hello!
Hi.
Good morning.
You called?
Okay, look, this is very...
now that we got that formality out of the way.
There was supposed to be that awkward pause of silence glaring at you. Okay, now, you are inside the library by her desk. No one's around. They haven't even opened for the morning. And she speaks in a quiet voice. I have been alerted... several hours ago, that one of our board of trustees has died very suddenly. Apparently from suicide.
What?
I need some people to carry the books from his study in his home back to the library and to return them to our collection.
Oh, and you want us to do it?
Yes, I thought this would be a good... learning experience for you on how to pick up books and take them back to the library.
I have a question.
Okay.
How wealthy was this guy?
Oh no.
Why are you
What can we expect to locate in the residence of this man?
Books. He was fairly wealthy due to inheritance, not to work. Mm. He was actually the only...
That's better, okay.
He is actually the only member of our four, now three, members, or three trustees, to be currently working. He worked at the university. Mm. Mm-hmm. Now, I want to emphasize that you need to be doing this with respect, and mm-hmm. especially with the gravity of a sudden, unexpected death, you should be sure to focus solely on finding the relevant books for us, not touching anything or wandering around or looking for anything on why anything might have happened, and then to bring the books back.
Is she, like, winking the whole time that she's doing this, or...?
Basically.
I can't imagine a Fluvia of Marsh winking.
It's more of heavier emphases on words and pauses. Instead of winks, it's just glares. Extended.
So, is she one of those people that says, I'm not telling you to do something while nodding emphatically yes?
Yeah. Not normally. She's pretty straightforward about what she wants, doesn't usually beat around the bush, or extend conversation. It's very clearly she's implying something about the situation.
Okay.
She wants us to investigate.
Yes.
If nothing else, then because having you walk all the way to his house just to carry some books back seems unusual. That's a scribe's job. Mm. You guys are not scribes, you're book hunters.
Mm, ostensibly.
I wouldn't know. This is
so let's get in there and kill some books.
Mm-hmm.
Kill some books.
So, is anybody else going to be there watching over his stuff?
Yes. The city guard is there already, making their cursory look over before they will be taking the body to the coroner.
How high is our sneak?
Your I don't sneak? Know, Emily. How high is your sneak?
You will...
As high as it needs to be.
You will be with me. You will have my authorization to be allowed to enter. I will remain downstairs with the guard.
Great. Do you have any duffel bags or anything? Yeah.
Duffel bags?
To put the books in, maybe?
You will need to bring your own bags.
Done. Got it. There's some back at the station.
Once again, never
mind. Definitely I
give up. I'm going to pick my
best,
or at least make a valiant attempt.
All right.
So, duffel bags.
Did you just shout one of your puns, but, like, not even in a moment where it was actually going to be helpful?
Did I miss the pun because there was just no setup?
She said, aw, shucks.
Oh.
I didn't catch it.
Oh, dear. Emily. Oh, dear.
Man, you're all ears, aren't you?
I'd tell you to pace yourself, but I guess once one pops, they all go.
Emily, did you have that one? That one's good.
I'll have some popping and locking.
Good. That's what you do to the criminals?
Nothing really too specific.
No, that's what you do to the criminals, right? You pop them and then you lock them.
Yeah, after I'm walking around incognito.
Jesus fuck.
Thunderdome!
Hell's bells. Now. Miles Blackburn, the now deceased trustee, lives in a stately house on the King's Way, the ancient street that leads up to the governor's estate in Westinghill. This is not the most expensive place to live in the city, but definitely one of the most impressive, due to history and the houses generally belonging to families for generations.
Fancy.
His home is three-storied, not too narrow. It's not a split row house or anything. He's got the full double wide. And has been very clearly kept up with expensive upkeep. You know it's his house because out front is a group of guards next to a wagon. And they're all kind of, well, a covered wagon, not just like a hay cart. So like a more impressive sort of carriagey deal. And they're all just kind of standing about with steaming mugs of coffee. And they're in no rush. The front door is open and, you know, guy walks in, guy walks out. That's about it. Effluvia, who has been walking ahead of you this whole time, nods to one of the guards on her way in, and no one really stops or questions you.
Got it.
That is the first time that has ever happened, probably.
What, they're just like, yeah, I guess they know what they're doing.
They're like, these guys are supposed to be here.
Well, we have a sense of authority with us.
Yeah. You do have that.
Oh, for some reason I thought that was also a corn pun, and I was like, looking for it.
I lost half a moment considering that possibility as well.
You guys are looking too hard.
Now Emily has us looking for puns where there are none.
Yeah. And you she's won. Barely
oh,
even
I'll
gotten
find
started.
Done it.
I've got plenty prepared. Just so you know.
So, as soon as you step through the entryway to this darkened yet regal house, paintings and lacquered wood paneling, you just smell the overwhelmingly wet and sweet stench of decay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gross.
Yeah.
Gross.
My mouth is watering. I don't like this.
You...
What?
You follow that into the next left, which is the sitting room. A large room, fireplace, bookshelves, and fancy and probably uncomfortable couches and armchairs.
I just realized, now we can take the opportunity to find the cat! Because we missed it before.
Okay. He owns a cat. You could have been briefed on that on your way. There was a cat. At some point.
Did the cat eat the body?
yeah. Well, you'll have to find that out.
Body eat the cat.
No, it definitely.
Because then we've got a way bigger problem on our hands.
Logan, you'll appreciate this. I bought a book last week that's called "Do Zombies Dream of Undead Sheep?" And it's a legitimate science text that won a legitimate science award on the anatomy of zombie brains.
And wow. Confirms that they can, in fact, eat the cat.
Well, of course they would eat cat.
Have you talked to your cat about gun safety?
Have you talked to your cat about the possibility of a zombie apocalypse?
No, that's the book your mom got me, remember?
Yeah. Are zombie apocalypses in there?
In
the book.
Oh, I don't know. I haven't read it yet. All I know is that I read the first chapter, and they were, like, very funny. So I was like, this is okay. I'm going to read this.
That's cool. Mm.
So... The body is still in one of the armchairs, however, it is concealed beneath a white sheet. The smell is very strong in here.
Is it very warm?
Not very warm.
Is he
not
warm?
Really. The body?
Yeah.
I thought you meant the room.
I meant the room, but...
No, yeah. I meant the body.
No. Michaela, it isn't really... It's a cold morning in the city, and it's an open house. So...
Open house?
They're
yeah.
already trying to sell the house.
Well, that was fast. We only just had a bit
this morning. To the man under the sheet.
They're trying
Wait,
to get people to apply to
bag.
This house.
Pay no attention to
the smell of dead, rotting things, because that'll be gone as soon as we move the body.
No, no, but, you know, they've got the front door open, and these houses are very drafty if you do not have a fire going at all times.
I don't know why I thought that was so funny.
Logan,
you're... You just think I'm funny.
You're pretty easy to set off tonight, I think, but...
I really do think you're funny, Em.
Yeah, I know.
You're pretty funny.
Oh, please. Mm-hmm. I know.
So, yes, Michaela, that is to answer your question. They probably are not trying to sell the house. They probably already have a buyer or someone to inherit it, but, you know.
Wait.
What?
I'm gonna ask you to stop talking.
Okay, so we have Ron Swanson saying, I'm gonna have to ask you to stop talking. What is that directed at?
Wait, but he's dressed up like a police officer.
I don't understand. Is that you?
Well, I wanted you to stop talking so I could ask you a question.
Okay.
This is actually what Corn Cop looks like anyway.
Okay, I had no idea.
He looks
like a stupider Ron Swanson, got it.
No, he looks like a normal Ron Swanson.
No matter what kind of Swanson you're buying, I want to know, who's this inheritor? Because there's going to be somebody expecting things to be in the house. I need to know before I collect evidence.
Mm-hmm. If you were to ask Effluvia, she would say he was well known to be a bachelor. He had no children, no siblings that I know of.
Alright, that makes it easier.
No, wait, you say bachelor. Is that the Victorian code for... actually gay, or are we talking actual bachelor?
Seeing as there isn't any real serious stigma or coding of language around homosexuality in this country, there wouldn't really be any reason for that.
Oh, so he's an actual bachelor, then?
Yeah.
What does that sound?
Emily, what are you doing?
She's turned into a tugboat. Iron bottle top. You pulled her tugboat. Okay,
Logan.
It just reached a good. It reached a good level. It makes a good sound now.
The role playing game is on the tracks.
Oh God.
We're taking this adventure off the rails.
And into the harbor.
I have to be awake at, 7 tomorrow, so...
Oh, fuck. All right, let's have an adventure.
And I am ill.
Okay, I put all of the important things into the duffel bag. Let's go.
Taylor, roll for important things. Taylor, I search for the plot.
Okay, you get a natural 20. On the table next to him... there is a half-full bottle of wine. On the ground is a glass. Or a wine glass.
It's the wine poison!
Do I have
detect poison?
Drink it.
I do not have detect poison.
Wait. Taylor, I waft it.
Alright,
Smell like poison.
Do you get a heady smell of red wine?
Fuck.
But you also get a lot of elements of decaying corpse.
Maybe I should go into the other room.
Maybe. Or do what you want.
I'm mostly good at knowledge religion and stuff.
I'm good at knowledge everything because I'm a bard.
And acrobatics, so...
I'm also apparently rather intimidating.
You hear steps in the hallway.
Oh, shit!
And in walks, tall man in a long brown coat, pipe in his mouth, throws his arm wide. Nobody touch anything anymore, all is dealt with. What are you doing with my body?
Your body?
Your body.
Are you Miles Blackburn?
No.
Then why is this your body? Because Miles Blackburn's the dead guy, isn't he?
He seems suddenly kind of on the wrong foot right there. I'm Sterling Farr, the detective in charge of this death.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
And I have already confirmed it is suicide.
It... how?
You should try this wine if you really believe that.
He draws out a piece of parchment from his jacket. Suicide note. Some may have missed it, but my excellent deducting...
Oh no, he's a shitty detective.
Has read the words.
No. He killed him.
That it was suicide. So, job done. We'll have the body out of here within 2 days or so.
We can fit that in the duffel bag.
2 days to get rid of a body?
It's a lot of paperwork, and I have lunch soon. It's like 9 in the morning.
He's a really shitty detective.
No, there's reasons.
This guy killed him. Like 100%. What the fuck is this?
Okay.
What?
Emily, what's this about?
What? You think he's keeping the body?
Are you implying necrophilia?
Where are you getting these things from?
I'm not implying any other kind of philia.
Oh, kinky.
Right.
I love the way he laughs after he says it.
So he tosses the note, which lands kind of on the torso of the corpse.
Wow, he's really bad with evidence.
Where can I ask where you found the suicide note?
Mm-hmm. Oh, just on the table next to the wine bottle. I was reading it outside.
As I wanted a detective, the natural. Aren't you supposed to like not move stuff at a crime scene?
Well, it's not a crime scene. He killed himself.
That's a crime. That is a sin.
This isn't Christianity, Logan. Your values don't apply here.
I take it as a personal affront to my morals.
You're a goddamn insurance agent. Shut up. No, sorry. You're an accountant with aspirations to being a business manager.
Excuse me. Right? I don't remember what I am.
All right, Michaela, you were saying something?
And I didn't write it down.
I was
down.
Asking if there was a pen next to the note.
No, there's not.
There's not a pen?
No.
Do we have any things back at the library that would have, like, his handwriting on it, like signatures or something?
Mm-hmm.
I forgot you were a forensics major, weren't you?
I am a fetchling who does not do forensics.
Thanks. I'm the detective.
No, in real life, though.
I can handle this.
She was not a forensic major.
I was also not a forensic
whatever,
major.
Whatever, you did the science.
Yes.
She did that do the science, yes.
What's his name?
Kyle Black.
Who?
The detective.
Sterling Farr.
Sterling what?
Sterling Farr.
Okay.
Did his parents hate him?
No. Maybe, I don't know.
He's playing a ukulele.
Logan, it's you.
No!
Alright, Michaela, good question. There would be some sort of writing back at the library, or, since Effluvia did say you would be going up to his study to collect any of the books he may have borrowed from the library, you could most likely find writing in his study.
I'm gonna say super politely to the detective then, well, if everything's wrapped up here for you, I guess we'll just do our job and collect the belongings of the library and bring it back, and could we have this piece of paper, you know, posterity and saving all things that have writing on them and stuff?
Oh, I suppose that's exactly what you libraries always do. By all means, I'll be outside getting more coffee.
Cool. Oh my god, you are going to be so useful.
And he pivots and walks out.
You are my new favorite party member.
The one with social skills.
You have social skills, holy shit.
Yeah, this is great.
I pocket the suicide in air quotes note.
Mm-hmm. Effluvia gives you a nod, says his office is on the third floor.
Let's go.
Alright.
Off to the office!
Okay, you guys hurry up the steps to find the house not deserted, you know that. Make your way up to his study. Now, as you kind of pick through nosing into rooms to see where you're going, you see very few of them are actually in use. There are a good number in the house, however, the doors are all shut up, and when you open them, you find it's just old furniture under drop cloths, or whatever you call it, when they're just meant to keep dust off things, and not for painting.
Yeah, okay. I remember. I know what you're talking about. Yeah, no, that makes sense, given that he was a bachelor in a family house.
Mm-hmm. The third floor has only two rooms. So once you reach the top of the stairs, there is either the large study or the bedroom.
I see.
Okay.
Study or bedroom?
Study! Bedroom. Oh, fuck.
What?
Well, Emily, it seems we will never agree.
Let's split for it.
You can split up. Or not.
No, we're not splitting the fucking party. We already move at a snail's pace.
We may be shitty at this, but we know better than that, Taylor.
Okay. Just wanted to...
Give us some credit, man.
Hey, I can handle this one on my own, you know.
Find one penny that I can.
I am a detective.
Alright. Evens is the study, odds is the bedroom. Even! It's a six.
You lied.
Study.
Okay. You lied. Okay. You lied. You just lied.
No, I rolled a d6. Evens, odds. Rolled a six.
We don't know that.
Emily, just take the L.
So, the study is, as I said, a large room full of bookshelves, a very large mapping table that has kind of been repurposed into a desk. Covered in papers that have spilled over onto the ground. There are books lying about, maps tacked to the wall.
Question.
Yes.
Is there a space on the wall where a fireplace would have been and a young woman's dead body in there?
What?
What an odd question.
While... To get a full assessment of that, you'd probably have to pull the bookshelves away from the wall to see if there's, like, an old, grate. Not grate. Whatever you call the
Excellent.
Hole where the fireplace is.
Sure.
That thing?
The fireplace?
You don't see either a woman's dead body or an old fireplace in the room.
Was this a reference? Was this some literary reference that I missed?
Yes.
What was the reference?
It's to the book that I'm reading out loud to Taylor.
Okay.
It's a children's book.
It is a children's book.
What?
It's called The Screaming Staircase. It's a good one.
Is this, like... I'm not even gonna ask.
Yeah, so that's your overall idea of the room.
I'm going to go straight to some of the loose papers and look for ones with a significant amount of writing on them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to gather up the books that we need and stick them in Corncop's bag.
Okay. First, I will say the library books are fairly easy to pick out because of, the numbers on them, but also because, how to put it, they have little adhesive stickers over the covers where the authors would be listed, simply because that's part of the cataloging system. You guys kind of need to tiptoe around authors being a thing, but we won't get into that right now, because that's a longer story. There are, by the way, only two? Yes, there are two library books. Both of them are old atlases that became out of date hundreds of years ago.
Interesting.
Michaela, in regards to notes, there are many with writing on them. Just a lot of general things. There are some old student papers from previous years that have, just other general academic stuff on it, but he has a lot of personal notes that you can cross-reference the writing for.
Okay, I'll pick up a couple of things with several different handwritings on it so that I can, see, just
sort of a spread of writing.
Do you want to roll a linguistics check for that one?
I think sure.
It's either perception or linguistics. I'd say linguistics.
You'd say linguistics.
Because that needs to be the most important skill in the game.
Well, please, I'm prepared for this one.
Pre-horned.
Well, I got a...
No.
Got a... Rolled a 4 plus 2. Got a 6. Woo! I'm real good at this, guys.
The point is, it looks like you had the ideas. So, that's the impressive thing.
Okay,
yeah.
What? You are able to read his handwriting. But apart from that, you can just say, yeah, it looks the same.
I mean, technically, linguistics is one of the skills that has this asterisk next to it, that unless you're trained in it.
But I have it because I'm a bard!
I am too! Not a bard, but I'm trained in it.
Shut up! Mm-hmm. I'm not trained in it, so
I have 7 in linguistics.
Why?
Why? Because I thought it was a smart thing to do.
She's in a book campaign.
Hey, I came prepared.
Yes, you
it's
did.
It's a trained open. You can't have it unless it's a class skill for you.
No, it just takes 2 skill ranks to put a single... Or 2 skill points to put a rank in.
Where are you finding me?
That's the only difference that between trained and untrained.
I my bed.
I'm always prepared.
I'll take them back with me, because I just because I'm bad at things doesn't mean that other people are bad at things.
Mm-hmm.
My specialty is not handwriting, but I know that I was uncomfortable with the fact that there was a note brought into the crime scene and told it was next to a thing, but there was no pen. It didn't seem to make sense to me.
Yeah, I mean, it would stand to reason if there wasn't a pen there. He either, you know, wrote it up here, or, as you suspect, someone else wrote it. We just lost Anna.
Hi, Anna.
But... the right thought. Michaela, have you even read the letter yet?
The letter?
Not the letter. The suicide note? Yeah.
No, but I assume that... Sure, let's do that since I was looking at handwriting stuff and failing at it. But
it's short, so I just wanted to include that it is simply, to whomever finds me, I have lived with this pain and found it insurmountable and must put an end to it. With my wine, I have taken a poison that shall take me to an easy annihilation. Signed, Miles Blackburn. And that's it.
What color is the ink?
Black.
Oh. Blackburn.
But yeah. So, Michaela, you have that note. You have, you know, you've pocketed a couple papers about cataloging theory that he seems to have written, and that's where you stand. Okay, what's next for you guys?
Assess the scene.
What? No, so you said the 2 library books were old maps.
Not old. They're, you know, a few hundred year, 300-400 year old, or probably.
From my phone. I'm going to try on my laptop. Nope, it still sounds like gunfire.
Okay. Michaela, they are, I guess, identified. It's just because they are pre-Amber Conquest, when the very large empire did its conquering, seized a lot of lands, and basically determined the new dominant cataloging system of the civilized world. So these are identified as right before that, and then became immediately obsolete. because of absorbed nations and whatnot.
Right.
Apart from that, there are no other library books here.
Right. What are his personal books
suspicious
on?
Mm-hmm. The overall thing you get is it's a range between traditional classics, you know, like the definitive masters sort of book collections you get, history, wide range, definitely a good amount of fiction, nothing too out there, but well-established popular stuff, and just classics. That was definitely the main focus of this library.
So he's clearly not a nonfiction person, and also not really a history person?
No, there's definitely, I don't want to say that, it's a good spread, but,
Well, you didn't. You didn't say it.
It is focused on the classics, yes.
The two library books were on the shelves with other things, even though...
No, those were on the desk.
They were on the desk. Were they next to... I mean, I'm looking through all the pages mm-hmm. on there, and you said there were student things. What were some of the other papers near those books?
Well, those actually stand out, because most of the papers around the desk are not recent. The ones... Like, they're not ancient, but the ones that have dates on them are from, like, 2 years ago.
Okay. So, is everything dusty?
Not around the desk, no. Or not on the desk. Around the desk, fair bit of dust.
Okay, so, dust
fingerprints?
Touched recently, rest of the room not used so much.
Effluvia explained on your way over that he was found by his housekeeper, who comes in every few days. It seems she doesn't get up here very often.
Okay.
I wouldn't get up there very often either. I want to go to his bedroom and see what's up in there.
Alright. It's just across the hall. This is a fairly Spartan room. Especially considering how expensive the furniture and dressings of the rest of the house are. There isn't really any decoration on the wall. It's a plain but, you know, comfortable-looking bed. Let's see what else. Standard things. A mirror, various dressers for... a lot of clothes and whatnot. What are you really looking to search for?
Does it look like it was, like, well kept, or like me, and like he made a nest and didn't really like make his bed and such?
No, it seems fairly well kept. So a complete counterpoint to the study.
Which was
chaos.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, in part it's just because he doesn't seem to have much in here in terms of personal effects or anything, so the stuff that is here stands out as just being kind of like, oh, rather than just buried. You get me?
Yes, I get you.
That, like, masterful languaging right there?
Yes, very masterful. So we have a dude who... wrote a suicide note that says he was in pain, took poison. He has an office that he does not use, but was touched recently in parts, but is very different than his actual living space as of late.
Yes. Which could imply either that he was spending a lot of time in there specifically and not sleeping, or, you know, somebody killed him and then wrote a letter in his desk.
I don't even... Okay. Okay. is the... You said the second floor had a bunch of rooms covered in sheets.
Yeah, the second floor isn't really being used.
And the first floor... What was on the first floor, aside from, obviously, the den with the dead body?
Yeah, there's a dining room, a large kitchen, another parlor, but this one in the back that's kind of looking off the hill over onto the city beneath.
Are any of those spaces looking like they're spaces that he uses often?
The kitchen.
Okay.
The dining room, not really as much. Okay. It's just more collected junk.
What sort of foodstuffs are in the kitchen?
Oh, so you're poking around the kitchen?
Yeah.
There's some food that's been left out on the counter.
What kind of food?
Meats, some bread, a hunk of cheese, you know, there are open cupboards, herbs, and like some salamis are hanging down from hooks. And there's, I guess there's a pantry as well.
Non-perishable items or less perishable items, I would say?
Not really sure. You know, the door's closed.
Okay, so the stuff that's out on the counter, mm-hmm. Does that look like someone's dinner that they were about to eat, or, like, the way that it sounds to me is, like, it was, like, a middle of a meal type thing and sort of just left?
It's kind of like it had been picked at and just kind of left about, okay. Rather than, like, a sit-down meal that someone walked away from.
Okay, so is it like I have company, like a cutting and I'm going to give them food things, like hors d'oeuvres?
You're not really sure. Like, there isn't a huge amount of food out there, but it is a cutting board with, like, meat and cheese and bread, half-eaten.
Okay. And not thrown away, just set down on the countertop.
Yeah, that one is left out.
So he decided to be nice enough to write a letter in a place where there isn't a pen for him to write a letter, but he had to do it in the middle of his meal.
That's in a different room. He might have just, you know, had this food out every day.
He eats half a sandwich, and then he sits up, he's like, yeah, it's time to kill myself, and then he goes upstairs, gets the pen, writes the note, leaves the pen, comes back downstairs to sit in a chair to drink poison wine, and then leave the note next to himself. Seems like a lot of work.
Maybe it just wasn't a very good sandwich.
But then he could throw it away. He seems like kind of a neat guy.
Hmm.
It stands out to me. It seems wrong.
I agree.
Because all of the spaces he seems to actually use are very well kept.
About the bedroom, I wouldn't call it well kept, just there wasn't much to put in it. Like, the bed wasn't made or anything like that.
Well, the best way to keep the space clean is to not put anything in it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not, like, he's orderly in a way. Like, he doesn't have extra things just 'cause everywhere.
Yeah.
I don't know. It seems weird. I don't know. I think I have all that I want from this space.
Okay. Party? Or rest of the party?
What?
Yeah, I mean, I'm...
Are you content with Michaela's sleuthing?
Yeah, absolutely.
He seems competent.
I mean, I am the best, but it is pretty good.
From an outside perspective, you watched a weird, sickly woman be, like, kind of nice to a guy, take a piece of paper, go upstairs, take a bunch of papers off a desk, squint at them a little bit, nod, stick them in a pocket... Look in the bedroom, poke at some meat and cheese in the kitchen, and then go, yep, I've got all I need from this.
Yeah, and they just, like, shuffled around behind you being like, yeah, I guess she knows what she's doing.
Look, none of us have a clue what's going on. You seem confident. We'll follow you.
Yep. We're in the business of being in a group of people. So, if you're going to take the lead, I'm going to follow you. Until, you know, it's time for authority to step in.
I think maybe because I'm a rogue I should sneak behind you, but That can be more flavor text than make me make a roll.
Okay. That sounds like someone who thinks they're going to fail the roll.
15 plus 9.
All right.
Taylor, I sneak.
You're sneaking.
Wait, I need to roll perception. Hold on. Hold. Well, I critically failed. You're really good at sneaking.
All right. Well...
You forget I was even there.
You also managed to sneak up on Effluvia, whose back is to you, when you step back into the sitting room. Hmm?
You're gonna get inspired.
No, she's just not really paying attention. She, though her body is blocking it, she's clearly lowered the, cloth from Blackburn's face and is looking at him.
In, like, a sad that her lover is dead kind of way?
You can't see her face.
Her lover?
The body language would be very clear in that.
Wait, her lover?
Yeah, is she swaying, like, really hard to the left, or is she swaying really hard to the right?
She what? Seems steady.
What's that what body language?
Anna, she... Michaela was, theorizing.
Yes. I wasn't sneaking into the room, though.
No.
It was more of me just being a sarcastic little shit than anything.
Mm-hmm.
Logan, you're the only one who's in there doing things.
I'm hiding.
Good okay. job.
If they're doing Proud things, you're surely right.
Alright, well, I'm gonna go into the room.
Okay.
Because that's where a dead body is.
I know, I'm hiding. Do I see anything?
What do you mean you're hiding? What are you looking at?
Wait, can I sneak into the room?
You
are sneaking.
No. Into the room before Michaela goes in.
Yeah, but you didn't do anything else, so we just kind of sat there for a bit.
No, I thought... Oh, I'm sorry, I got confused.
yeah, no, she
I
is...
I was behind Michaela such that, like, I couldn't see what she was seeing.
No. You just can't see... what Effluvia is
she's blind, actually.
Because she's in the way. Logan, she is unaware
Taylor.
Of you.
Taylor, I opened my eyes.
Okay. Uh-huh. Effluvia is still looking at the body. She's kind of tilting her head a bit.
She's faking it.
Yeah.
After a few more seconds, she just straightens up and lifts the cloth back over his face.
I think she did it.
She wrinkles her nose and goes to look out the window.
Do we know if Effluvia... Is Effluvia on the board?
No.
Okay. Because the fact that there are four people on that board is inherently suspicious to me because they're always supposed to have odd numbers of people to break ties.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
So now they do, which is a little bit suspicious.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
So I'd like to posit
politics.
That. And maybe some of the other board members have a vested interest in not having that guy around.
Right.
Interesting.
That's fair. I'm going to come back into that room now.
Okay.
Poking at meat and cheese. Miss Effluvia, ma'am?
She turns, look at you.
I think we've done all that we can here. I think any other questions or insight we can gain would best be sought elsewhere.
And you are sure you have done a thorough search for these books?
I have checked under every... Moat of dust. I have everything.
Whoa, hold up. You know what we didn't look at? The dead body.
Do you think he's sitting on a book?
We might as well check.
Okay, we lift the body and throw it on the floor. No.
Yes, we lift the body and throw it on the floor.
Okay, Emily lifts the body and throws it on the floor.
As soon as you touch it, beneath the cloth, your hand just kind of squishes in, and a rancid smell, like 10 times magnified of what you had been smelling before, just explodes outwards.
Okay.
What sort of poison did he drink to make him decompose like this? Jesus Christ.
Yes, that's a good question.
Do you guys know how long he's been dead?
No, I guess no. We should ask that.
You might not have checked.
How long has he been dead? I figured it was a sudden thing based on how people were talking about it. Like, he was okay last night and woke up this morning dead.
Or they just found him dead, didn't they?
Yeah.
Well, no. You see, he killed himself, so he would have known about it.
Oh, he would have known about it, that's true.
Well, he doesn't live with anyone, and he was found by his housekeeper who comes in every third day. So it's likely he has been dead for 2 or 3 days at this point.
Yeah, but you also said it was, like, kind of cold and...
Well, no, I mean, it was a cold morning. You asked me if it was warm in the house.
Okay.
And there hasn't been a fire going for a few days, if anything. Yeah. No, this is a few days of decomposition. There's been a bit of bloating, and Emily seems to have squeezed a bit of that out.
Nice. Okay.
Well, you know, gotta be a true detective. Real detective work gets messy sometimes, you know.
Fair enough. Who am I to get inside the mind of a corn?
All right. Exactly.
Only I could be inside the mind of a corn.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Here now.
In that case...
There's no books underneath him. He's super decomposed.
Not
are there
super.
Any... Well,
he's
that's...
getting on there, yeah.
Okay.
Go on. Mm-hmm.
Are there any wounds? Or does it look like poison was a thing? Like bruising? That's weird, because I'm going to assume that when she tossed this body, the sheet came off of it.
I assume she didn't get so far as tossing it, but she has removed the cloth.
Okay.
Propriety would, you know...
My computer really doesn't like Skype.
Don't toss that body.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah. There's discoloration, swelling, the eyes are bugging out, but no wounds that you can see, Michaela.
Okay. I don't have the know-how or technology really to do anything with this dead body, so there's no reason for me to want to look at it more than that.
Mm-hmm. That's totally fine.
We need, like, John's Inquisitor character here.
Blood biography.
Yep. Taylor's probably so happy that that's not a part of our campaign anymore.
It's such a dumb spell. It's like treasure map.
Hey, Taylor, nice mystery you've got there. It's a shame if someone solved it.
At a skin send, that's still such a dumb spell, and it's so gross, and I love it.
Anyway, if then you are done here, then you may depart.
Right.
We depart.
Wait, what about the cat? We need to find the cat.
It's in the duffel bag.
Wait, what?
Yes, that's why it's moving.
When did you
She didn't.
No, you not put cats in duffel bags. Corn Cup, take it out.
It's not in the duffel bag.
You'll startle the cat.
Where's the cat here?
You want to go looking for the cat?
Yep.
Anna wants to go looking for the cat. I will allow her to do the thing. I would like to leave the space that smells disgusting.
Okay, yes. Michaela, you may step outside. Right,
in the meantime,
Anna,
I'll be right back.
You're going to have to do like a full in-depth search of the house for that. This cat is not easy to find right now.
You want me to roll perception for it, or what?
Yeah, it's not... You did not see this cat going around the house, so clearly it's hiding.
And... 14 plus 6. 20.
I don't want to be like a total rube, but I do need to get to bed because I need to be up at 7 because I have to be work at 9 and it takes like an hour to get there and I'm sick and mm-hmm. I would like to sleep. How much longer do you think this is going to be?
I was going to say under 20 minutes.
Okay, that's fine.
All right, speed run. Let's do it.
Just... All right, anyways. So
all right, Taylor, I glitched through the wall.
What?
Taylor, I find the corner of the room and I just start jumping.
You somehow trip into the boss fight. Roll for initiative.
We're going off the map. Taylor, can I glitch to the end credits?
Yeah, Anna, you roll a 20?
No, I rolled a 14, but I have a plus 6.
Okay, well, you basically sniff out this cat. You go a-hunting.
Yes! I am the cat whisperer.
And you track it by trails of dandruff or whatever, like little fluff balls up all the way to the third floor, crawling on your hands and knees. You peer beneath the bed and there is I guess like a really shaggy bobcat.
What?
Under the bed.
A fucking bobcat?
I mean, that's your first impression.
The wild animal bobcat.
It's, you know, gray, really wild, crazed fur, like possum, gray and spiky, kind of like that. I mean, I say bobcat because it's, like, the size of a medium-scaled dog.
Wait a minute. Taylor, does he have a large does he have a medium-sized opossum? Or a small-sized opossum?
No, he has a cat the size... A cat, like a middling-sized dog with fur like a possum.
What the fuck is that?
It's a big cat.
Can I roll Knowledge Nature to find out what kind of cat it is?
Sure.
Because I have that, and it's nice.
So did you get the cat?
Hang on!
She's eye to eye with it, and it's, like, snarling.
Wow.
Is that a plus 4? That can't be. That's gotta be a plus 6. Why do I have a plus 9 written down? That doesn't make any sense. 18.
Okay. One moment. I need to.
I wrote really well. Why can't they roll just when it matters?
I don't think I have a cat breed generated. I don't have an actual name for it.
What you want help? I can help you.
Oh no, sorry, you that's a 4. So that's a 16.
Okay.
Norwegian forest cat? They're very large and very puff.
Well, mm-hmm. It may look...
They've got a fucked up face.
They do have a silly face.
What? Norwegian forest cats
are crazy. It's like a fucking Persian.
No, they don't.
It's the Alola form.
You know what? Let's just call it, It literally just looks like a gray bobcat.
Okay. Alright. Okay. I'm going to leave the cat. I don't have any.
It opens its teeth, like, its mouth, draws back its lips.
Yeah, I'm going to leave the scared cat alone.
Let's put it in our bag.
No, I do not tell Corn Cop where the cat is. I couldn't find the cat.
Hey, Corn Cop has eyes of his own.
Corn Cop, not... no.
Alright. But, Anna, beneath the bed, under the frame, where it seems to have fallen out of sight, you do see a small silver ring.
I grab the ring.
And then you book it.
Never trust anything.
I everyone knows shirts.
I have a cool ring too. We can be ring friends.
What?
Wow.
What?
What did she say?
I also have a really cool ring. We can be ring friends.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. You now have a small silver ring with elaborate scroll work on it. Makes it hard to actually read what it says.
Rich people can't be practical.
Hmm?
Because rich people can't be practical with their inheritance.
Nope. Never. And on that note, with you guys leaving the house, I think will be a good place to end for the evening.